Hey, good day, Believers Fellowship, whatever time of the day it is to you. I hope you're experiencing the grace of God, kind of trying to stay dry, all the rains that are coming and going. Got a passage I want to share with you, just a few minutes today. Psalms 28, listen to this. Blessed be the Lord, because he has heard the voice of my supplication. In other words, God's hearing what we're praying, amen. The Lord is my strength, and the Lord is my shield. It's also my mask, all right? My heart trusts in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart exults. And with song, I shall thank him. Verse 8 of 28 says this, and the Lord is their strength. He is a saving defense to his anointed. Save your people and bless your inheritance by their shepherd also and carry them forever. Amen. What a great word from the word of God today. And just to let you know that, and remind you, as you already know, that the Lord is our strength and our shield. He's our refuge. And we can trust in him during this time. Said he's heard the voice of our supplications. That means one thing. He's hearing, but there's one other element there. We're praying. So let's remember to be praying and trusting the Lord. Announcement-wise, just for the week, as far as it goes out, next week is kids camp. So Sunday morning, they'll be leaving. So let's be praying for them as they're getting ready and praying for our counselors. And as they make the preparations that need to be made, a pretty small group that's going with multiple leaders that need to be there to handle the groups that are there. So it's not a massive group, but be praying for their safety and their protection. Obviously, their health. We're doing everything we can to be protective of them and of our counselors as well. I want to say this, as I've been getting the news and watching like each and every one of you do, especially concerning COVID or really any other of the crazy issues that are going on around us at one time. Whoever thought 2020 would be so bizarre. But anyway, I just want to encourage you to listen carefully, not just to hear report. Now, I've said it before, the media has a way of just blowing it up. They're going to take it and it can magnify it. But to learn how to listen and be discerning, take time to research on your own. Take time to investigate what you're hearing to see what's actual and factual and be on top of those kind of things. We have to be discerning, especially Christians in the day and age that we're living in, if we're going to be what God's called us to be. So take note of that. We're encouraging people to, as the Lord gives them a word and peace about coming, get back in fellowship. The numbers are beginning to grow in our groups. If you can see here, you can't really tell a lot of dimension with a video like this, but those chairs and those rows that are there, 1, 2, 3, 4 rows, there would normally be 8 rows there, all right? But we have taken out the middle rows. There's plenty of distance. We're practicing separation. We're asking families to keep the distance between them and the next family. We've got a lot of things just spread out at both locations. It is the same way. We're continuing to help people that feel like they need to continue to wear masks. Our greeters, our ushers at the doors are always wearing masks. The pastors have masks on them. We will put them on if needed, all right? If you come up with a mask, we'll do it. I don't preach with a mask. I'm plenty of distance from everyone else. And so, band doesn't sing with masks. So we do practice the distancing that we need to be practicing, though. Understand they're doing an excellent job. Those people who are working each week to bring the services to you. Can't say how much more that it's come to mean to me just personally, the personal sacrifice of those here each week to make these things happen with our live stream, as well as with our in-person services. They're doing a great job. We are taking care of everybody as much as possible. As we know, when needs are there, we rise to meet those needs. We're continuing to serve the Lord as many ways possible. But I think one of the important things about you, where you are, making decisions about being in church, out of church, is obviously your health. You don't come if you're sick. If you're symptomatic, we would ask that anyway. I know a lot of people say, well, I'm not going to let a sickness keep me from the church. Hey, you don't want to make other people sick, so continue to do that. Praise the Lord, we haven't had any cases, actual cases, at either campus in our family, of church family as a whole, of COVID on any level. We've had some people who've been around it at work and have been quarantined. We've had our own staff members, people in the worship team, when they've been around others at work that stayed home and went through quarantine, and we're practicing their just safety for your concern. So we're taking careful, diligent oversight in these regards. So feel free to come. In fact, this Sunday, for every family that does come, we've worked with our San Felipe Baptist Association and churches there, and also with FEMA, and gotten some masks for our families. So if you have a need for a mask, we are giving out packages of 5. These are fully safe and clean masks. They are reusable. They're 100% cotton, multi-layered, so you can use them and then wash them at the end of the day. And then, so there'll be 5 in each little pack. We're going to give out 1 pack and there's no charge. It's just to every family in our fellowship at both campuses. So you show up Sunday, and we'll get you a pack of these masks to wear. Again, when it comes back to the numbers you're looking at, I got Impact Magazine, a local Magnolia Tomball paper, put out 61% increase in one of the zip codes, 7735. I thought it was 77355, but it's 77375. All right. And they said there's been this tremendous spike there of COVID cases. Now, that's one of the highest population area codes for zip codes for Tomball and Magnolia, 77375. In fact, it's 20,000 people stronger than the other surrounding little zip codes around it. But they were talking about this tremendous increase of 61%. Look at those numbers, break it down, look at where they're at, and you'll see that that means there were 20 more people that got sick this period of time than were sick the last period of time. That's what 61% represented. They don't always give you the real facts of what's going on. They want to give you the largest looking number to scare you more. That's, again, the media that we're living in, whether it's printed media or TV media, it's all about the spectacular. But as I looked around the spring, around those air codes there, there may have been a small increase of there. I think you're looking at, in spring, I've got some numbers here in front of us while I'm looking down. I think there were 48 active cases recorded, new active cases recorded in the last period of time. I think they do it weekly or every other week, however that works. In the 77388, there were 48 cases more. In the 77379, there were like 70 new active cases. But again, they talked about the whole of Harris County, there were 14,000. 14,000 is a lot of people, and I pray those people, you know, and many of them are recovering. Majority are 98.something%. We don't want to see anybody suffer any at all, much less to die from it. But in those spring zip code, there were no deaths there. But remember, when it says 14,000 people, that's just Harris County. There are almost 5 million people in Harris County. So don't let fear fill your heart and mind. Keep the peace of the Lord Jesus in your heart and mind, and be praying for each other and praying God's grace and mercies over each other. And let's see what the Lord will do for us. But again, if you're sick, don't come to church. Your pastor loves you, but he doesn't want you getting the rest of the flock sick. So we'll oversee you. Tune in online and see what the Lord's doing. I didn't want to take 7 minutes and 24 seconds of your time. I did, but it's important stuff, I'm telling you. So come Sunday, we'll have those masks available for each family that comes. God bless you, and thank you for the time.